Hello, my soccer universe, and welcome to this week's Serie A review. I had a gut feeling. I didn't mention it because, you know, I didn't want to jinx it or whatever, but I had a gut feeling that this might be the round where the two unbeaten ones will at least get challenged. So they did. Both lost, so we have no unbeaten team anymore in Serie A. So, which kind of makes the whole thing, the whole league, a little bit more interesting, although on the other side, if I think about it, it's not necessarily the kind of interest that I would like to have as a Milan fan. I wanted to all go up into a secure championship. I'm not sure. I think it might be that the microphone just went out, so let me disconnect here and we'll do it the old-fashioned way. I don't know what happened here. Some technical troubles. In any way, I'm gonna continue now with the with the cell phone microphone. So yeah, the league got tighter. We had a few remarkable results and also a couple of really remarkable games in there. We're also gonna talk about it. I'm wearing Venezia, who had the biggest win of the weekend, at least when in terms of expected points, because no one saw them winning at Bologna. But we're not starting in Bologna. We're gonna start actually our journey in Bergamo, where Mario Pasalic completely dominates the game against Spezia. Atalanta winning 5-2. Yes, they were down by 1-0, but then Pasalic scores two, Zapata with a penalty, making 3-1 in the second half. Pasalic sets up Muriel, and Muriel sets up Malinowski, but Zola pulls one back. So Atalanta looking rather good ahead of their Champions League adventures, playing against Young Boys in Bern. Lazio Juve looks very much like a Juve win, two penalties by Bonucci, but both penalties were justified. So it clearly has to be said that way, and Lazio just did not have anything to break down Juve. So overall, it was a deserved win that it came with two penalties. So be it. It is not something where Lazio fans can say, yeah, the refs were in Juve's hands, so Juve get that one. Milan's performance at Fiorentina. I mean, in a way, they got Vlahovic. I mean, first off, I did not see this game. I felt really not well on Saturday evening. And I think at 8:30 or 8 o'clock, I was already in bed and more or less slept the entire night. And then I watched the highlights in the morning, thinking about watching the whole game, which probably I should have done. But what I saw in the highlights, that overall, Milan played actually quite well, especially the first half. This should in no way have been 2-0 to Fiorentina. If this goes 1-1, 1-2, or let's give it even 2-2, 2-2 half, I think this is a much more accurate reflection of how that half went. The first goal for Fiorentina was an absolute gift of Tata Ruggiano. Now that the Milan fans have heaped so much praise upon Tata Ruggiano, he makes a clear mistake. I mean, the corner kicks, he pads it down to the feet of Duncan, who can pull it in the net. That was deflating. But then Zlatan needs to have at least one goal. Leao also great actions. There was an equalizer, at least in there, that you go down 2-0 just with a stroke of halftime through a brilliant Saponara strike, it has to be said. Kind of set the tone. And then in the 60th, again, Milan trying to control the game, but then you run to the counter-attack and Vlahovic, boom, scores a third. And that would, you would think that the game was done there. But the way the game was going, no, you never had that feeling. And very quickly, Ibra scores a brace, 62nd and 67th. And I really had the feeling, even though watching it, now the equalizer is there. Maybe they finished 3-3. The one thing that Lask didn't do. However, Vlahovic, Cesar by Gonzalez, makes it 4-2, putting the game to bed, but Milan with an own goal could pull even one back. So yeah, performance of both of my teams, both together they scored 6 goals, but they conceded 7, so you can see I'm not so happy. However, overall, defensive errors aside, I actually thought that Milan still had a shot, that they are a really, really good team, and this might have been just a blimp along the way. I hope. Then next up, they play against Sassuolo, who mentioned only a 2-2 against Cagliari, who are really struggling. So Sassuolo is an opponent that Milan never plays very well against, but at least I have some hope that this will go well. As I said, I'm wearing Venezia. Venezia gets a 1-0 win at Bologna, where I saw the second half. The winning goal came through Okereke. And I think it was overall, yeah, I mean, they defended in the last half hour to the last, but they had some counterattacks, and I think one in stoppage time, where they were 4-2, and then the player who has the ball, instead of passing, he takes a shot from outside of the box, and I'm thinking, how stupid can you be? Play it out, make it a 1-2, and you have a sure goal, and they had another big chance. So I thought Venezia did overall deserve, thanks to the defensive prowess, and Bologna, yeah, they threatened once or twice, but I felt it was all right. But why I really wanted to mention is I was watching it in my office, and my daughters came and were talking. Ah, that's interesting. There are interesting colors there. And then I think just when it came, Okereke scores, and you know, I want Venezia to win in a way. So I was, yuhu, why are you for them and not for us? I said, no, in this game, I'm for Venezia. And why? And I said, well, I have this beautiful shirt. And also, you know, Venezia, I have this beautiful shirt. And then they said, and against whom they are playing? Bologna. And I said, you know, Bologna is the home of spaghetti bolognese, which is one of your favorite foods. And Venezia is the home of tiramisu, one of your other favorite foods. So basically, they both said, wow, so it's spaghetti against tiramisu. And I said, yeah, and if you look at the Venezia shirt, it even looks a little bit like tiramisu. That shirt, I don't know. Serie A review coming. And then my older one says, well, that game will decide. Whoever wins, that's my favorite food. Favorite food is not tiramisu. There, you got it. So you can teach the kids with soccer, which feeds into the video that I just did. I was a little bit surprised that Inter against Napoli played already 6-0, which was not good because Lasco was playing. So I saw only the last half hour and I saw the highlights. Boy, was that a great game. Absolute barnstormer. Zielinski gave Napoli the lead. Then Calhanoglu converts a penalty. Now he's the official penalty taker. And even then, after corner, Sadza Perisic who, to give Inter 2-1 half-time lead. In, I have to say, a game that was rather even. Napoli playing in more Maradona shirts. Yeah, my Serie A review for the Napoli shirts, that will be, I should make a episode just for Napoli, to be honest. So yeah, it was already, from what I could see, a very interesting game. It was more even that Inter took the lead. It was maybe a little bit of a fluke in a way. And just when Napoli was pressing for the equalizer, you know, Osimhen had to come off. I think there was a lengthy injury break. Osimhen had come off, Petagna came on. Then something similar happened with Dzeko a little bit later. However, Lautaro Martinez makes it in 3-1 with a really good counterattack. And then the game kind of stalled for roughly 20 minutes until Dries Mertens makes it 3-2. Game on. And then Napoli asserted the pressure. And like Milan, Napoli really played well. However, they fought against an Inter team this time that was not about to give in at all. However, they should have conceded. I mean, Mario Ruiz header. Handanovic doesn't even save it properly, but he gets enough of the hand on there that the ball just lampoons high. I mean, it was a header onto the ground, comes up, he gets the hand and then lampoons high, it goes on to top of the crossbar, when I really thought it will go in. And then Anguissa, in the last minute of the game, suddenly channels his inner Maradona, gets past three players, makes a fabulous cross in that Dries Mertens puts high. That needs to be the equalizer. And I think an equalizer wouldn't have only been a just result for that game. An absolute Serie A classic. But it also would have been the result that I wanted. With Milan losing, I really wanted... I was okay if Napoli go 1 point clear and Inter still having 6 points. Now, with that, Inter is within 4 points of both Milan and Napoli, and you can definitely make a case that Inter are the big winners of this round. Because now they are also the favorites to win the championship suddenly. So a huge win for Inter. They do have a slightly tough schedule coming up. I mean, not next week, Venezia, but Venezia Spezia. Oh, maybe it's not that hard. But then they have to play Roma. So, you know, there is some stuff. But kudos to Inter. They really did well. Napoli has started a tough schedule. They have Lazio, then Udine, then have to play Atalanta. So yeah, we will see what Napoli is made of. So every team has kind of a little bit of a rough schedule. It was first Inter, then Milan, then also Inter a little bit in there, and now Napoli. So that will go a long way. Roma got a win, a late win against Genoa through two goals by a 17-year-old Afena Gian or Felix, who scores in the 82nd and in stoppage time to give Roma in their specially created third jersey. That's why I put the yellow jersey up there. Again, the Roma section of my Serie A review will also be a long one. I think over it was a deserved win. So yeah, that was it. We have two games on Monday. So when this post, maybe one will be already in the books. But if you want to see the results for those, I'll refer to the StatsCast where you also see all the chances and how everything is developing. In any case, please drop a line below if you want to add a little bit more to what was happening in Serie A this weekend. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Sorry for the sound, but I don't know what the microphone is doing. In any way, I will talk to you soon. Bye. Hey there, I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, here are some videos and playlists that you might enjoy too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel and hitting the little bell so that you get updated whenever something happens in my soccer universe. And with that, have a wonderful day. Bye.